Hello, in today's video I'll show you how to create soft body physics like this by using Unity's game engine. Let's get this started. First things first, setting up a project. I'll be using Unity 2019.3 and we can start with new project with Universal Render Pipeline preset. As template, you already have the sample scene. We don't need any of those things, get it out of here, delete everything, and with everything deleted, we got nice clean project without any nonsense. Next step. By default, Unity have 3D project setup, and today we're gonna be working in 2D, so let's switch it to 2D. Next, we create 2D renderer, assign it to graphics settings, and project setup is done. With this out of the way, we can go to fun part, creating soft bodies. Ha! Just joking, you also need couple Unity packages. First package we're gonna use is 2D Sprite. It allows to add the sprite asset properties like pivot point, borders, or physical shape. Second package is 2D Animations. This one allows to rig sprite with bones, usually can be used for animations or, in this case, soft body simulation. So, with packages installed, we will need sprites. They will be reference for our soft body shape. I made couple different geometry shapes, so that's what we're gonna be working with. Also imported this background from my previous game. Yeah, it's kind of out of context, but it looks pretty, and I don't want you to stare at grey background, so I will leave it here. So, to make a shape soft, we'll be simulating it with physics. And to simulate object with physics, we'll give them rigid bodies. Hit play, and of course nothing happens. Our shape just a one big object. If we want to simulate soft body, we have to simulate every point of object separately. Okay, so how do we do that? Well, remember that package that allows us to create bones? Let's use that. Each bone will act like a separate point on object, which will be simulated. So let's open Sprite Editor window, select Options, Sprite Skinning, and assign bones to our shape. And this part depends on shape itself. For example, for a square, 4 bones would be enough. 1 bone per each vertex. Of course, if this square in game world would be like a really big object, maybe it would be a good idea to give it more resolution and assign more bones between vertexes. But in this case, let's leave it at 4. And this rigging works for any shape you have, just go around the perimeter and assign bones. Next, we go to Weights tab and generate automatic weights. What this does is determines how much each bone can deform sprite around itself. With weights assigned, we save changes and get back to scene view. And our shape is still one object, we don't see bones yet. For that, we have to add Sprite Skin script. Don't worry, you don't have to write any code here. This script is included in package we imported previously. And if we assign script and hit create button, now we have bones. And you can see how each bone or a point can manipulate our sprite shape. Awesome! Next, simulation. We assign rigid bodies and colliders to each bone. However, if we try to play, now each point clips with each other and it's total mess. That's not what we want. So, next step is attach each bone to each other with springs. This will prevent bones going too far away from each other, connect them together in one big object, and will give the springy, bouncy, soft body feel. How this works is we will take each bone and give it 3 spring components. These 2 springs will be connected to bone neighbors. For example, for bone 1, connected neighbors would be bone 12 and 2. And for bone 2, bones 1 and 3. So, first 2 springs, done. Third one will be connected to bone that is on the opposite side of the shape. With this method, we go around the entire shape perimeter and set up every bone. We can repeat this step for any shape we have. And with this done, we can try out our soft body. And it is working nicely. Now we can put multiple shapes, drag them around and see how they interact together. Pretty cool, but we are not over. For different use cases or projects, you probably want to adjust soft body stiffness, how rigid, soft, or bouncy it is. So, for this, we usually control spring tension or damping. I found that values of spring tension of 5 and damping of 0.3 works nicely. Also, we can adjust rigid body mass or drag to get different results. You just need to play around with these values and see what works for you. Another thing I added is physics material. It's not necessary, but I like how these soft bodies interact with material assigned. And here we have 2 rectangles with different stiffnesses. And if we try to play, you can see how bodies with different stiffnesses interact differently. Next thing I want to talk is performance. Yeah, it's not the most performance-friendly simulation. Each shape have rigid body and multiple springs, and that take a lot of computing power. Depending on your device, you might want to keep number of shapes not too big. Of course, performance depends on shape size itself. Let's take an example. We got 2 different shapes and immediately we noticed that they have different number of bones. Square have only 4 bones, while Plus have 24. 6 times the difference. So that means we can have 1 Plus or 6 Squares, and that would require same amount of computing power. So conclusion would be, when making shapes, try to keep number of bones lower. That means more shapes can be simulated at the same time. Now I showed you how to do shape setup by hand, and depending on shape size, it might take some time. So solution for this would be script that generates shape for us. However, for this video I didn't wrote script. In sake of learning, I wanted to show you how it can be done by hand. But even setting up shape by hand shouldn't be a big deal. Create it once, make it prefab, and later just drag and drop prefab into your scene. And with this, I think I showed you everything. If you would like to try it for yourself, I put the whole project for download, link in description. Try it, play around, and let me know if it was helpful. Also, if you like this video, be sure to check out my soft body physics game called Jelly Splash Adventures. I made it using this exact method. Alright, that's been it, see you in the next video, bye bye!